Hi. Okay, I had some requests for the Cormeaux Bouclé, that's what I call it anyways. So here, I'm going to try to set this on a pile of wool and see if I can get this video going for you. Here you go. Okay, that works. Okay, I've got a, right with this is right here, and I'll have to like let the twist out after a bit. This is a crochet cotton. And I'll put I should put the yarn in a bowl so it can lose some of the twist. I'll do that right now. It's on a, what do you call them? What are the things to poke up to hold your bobbins? Anyways, it's just sitting on there. So this, what I'm doing right here, this is a single of Cormeaux. You can do this as a single of anything. I raise Cormeaux, so it's primarily what I do. And this is a single of crochet cotton because it's strong. It could handle twisting whichever way. I could use a silk thread. I could use a regular thread. I opted for crochet cotton right now because I won't be dyeing this one. What I'm doing is holding it at an angle and letting things wrap on very loosely. I'll start treadling. Wrap on very loosely and then scrunching it up, wrapping it on very loosely, and then scrunching it up. And then when I go back to ply with my Cormeaux single, these loops will all loosen up loosen up more. And then I could wrap in between them. And then these loops will kind of puff up. And then the single will secure the yarn onto the crochet thread. And that'll give me not a firm yarn, it'll be a very soft yarn, but it'll give me a firm, secure yarn that won't come undone or anything like that when I'm knitting. I'm going to take this ball off right now so I can get some of the twist out of that crochet cotton. Don't try, like, see this? This looks probably ridiculous or not good construction. But these are actually what make the yarn poofy and adorable when you go back to ply it. Right now, it could look kind of haphazard and maybe not particularly stable for a yarn. But what it does when you go back and ply it is you could put the second strand of Cormeaux or whatever critter you're working with, however you want, and it just, the plying secures it just like it would a single. So this essentially is kind of like a loose spun single here because there's nothing stabilizing it. And then the Cormeaux will wrap around the other way. I'll ply back the other way and then it'll give me all these nice little puffy little things and end up with a pretty finished yarn. So this will probably be maybe a three-part video? I don't know. Okay, now it's getting a little bit funky here because I got to let some of the twist out of the crochet thread. This doesn't happen when you're using sewing thread, but sewing thread isn't as strong, and I didn't have any silk sewing thread. I would love to have like a silk crochet cotton. I could make a silk crochet cotton, but I don't want to put all that time into my single that I'm just going to cover up 100%. So, shame on me. Gotta support the economy too. Okay, so I'm just putting that back. I monkeyed with it. See these little loops here that look peculiar? It's actually, you can see that? Why is that so foggy? It looks like I'm having a migraine. Come on. I'm going to loop that over there so it's will look more secure to you. I don't know, maybe you don't care. But okay, so there you go. I'm gonna do this and scrunch it up and give me lots of little crazy little loopies and things. Crazy, crazy, crazy little loopies. That crazy, crazy, crazy little loops around. And then I'm going to, it'll all come out all curly and fun when I go to ply. The Cormeaux that I'm using right now, I had originally, because I knew I was going to do this, I had spun the single going counterclockwise on my wheel. that needs to be the case if I don't want it to unspin while I'm doing this, because then I'm going to go back and ply the other way. Generally, people do their boucles with mohair because mohair, the little loops stay very loopy. I used to grow Angora goats. I don't anymore, so I started doing it with other fibers that I raise, and I like it a lot. It does not give the sheen that mohair does, but this is next to skin soft, and my cormo, my mohairs, they grew older, and they didn't continue to provide the kid soft fleeces, so I like this. So can you, let me see, can you see what I'm doing? Okay. I see. It's hard to tell when I look at the camera. I'm not seeing my hands. So there you go, like that. Scrunch up. See if I can move my hands where you can see it better. Scrunch up. Go like that. Scrunch up. Go like that. Scrunch up. Go like that. Scrunch up. And I like the scrunchies to be fairly close to each other. If I want a thick yarn, so I'm going to use a big needle and have a quickie project, that's, who doesn't love that? And so I'm just very, very crazy loopiness. There's nothing uniform about this. I'm not giving it any thought whatsoever. I could see a piece of hay. Okay, let me see if I can bring this treadle backwards a little bit so I can bring this up to you so you can see. See if I get a clearer picture. That is not clear, is it? Do any of you know about lighting? I'm sure it's, let me see if I could get, is it clear that way? It is not clear that way. Let's see. Let me see. That way? That way? No. That's, you,